Magandang araw sa lahat. Ngayon po ay August 19, 2020. Yung trading natin ay tapos na po yung trading natin. Our trading is in the stock market starting from 9:30 until 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Because of this COVID, they adjusted it up to 1 o'clock. But before, there is a normal situation. There's no COVID-19, it is coming until 3:30 in the afternoon. But now, it's only 1 o'clock. So, ang market natin ngayon ay bumaba ng 1.86%. So, yesterday, nakalampas po siya dito sa ating area of yung incline resistant natin, no? Withdraw natin yan. Now he's nagpo-pull back po siya hanggang dito sa may EMA 50. So pero kung lagyan natin ng box ito, ito yung box na lumabas. Okay, hindi pa masyado siya na break yung red line, the center. So ngayon nagpo-pull back po siya sa ating EMA 50. So we will see tomorrow kung mag sa sideway ito or he will go down again on this area. So titingnan natin. So now we will see the indicator. Our ADX is now is above 25. Our positive and negative BMI is below 25. So it means this one is not hindi pa masyado strong yung ano natin. So we will see tomorrow kung mag green candle siya. But for me, the best is if it'll go this area and retest this green line going up and then retest. This is good, but for now it seems that it is a false breakout for the green line area. So if not, it will go this way sideway and break this one. We will see the price action of PCI. So now let's go to the stock that ang presyo ay nasa taas na ng lahat ng exponential moving average. I am focusing on this stock which is has a strong trend. Yung mayroon po siyang strong trend, na if the price of a certain stock is above, this is the condition, AMA 50 and AMA 20, it is considered as a strong trend. And another condition is if the stock is above all exponential moving average, yung presyo, it is a strong trend. So but we need to check the indicator. So now we will see first one, this CDC. This is the new companies na lumampas yung presyo sa ibabaw ng lahat ng exponential moving average. So kung tingnan natin tong CDC, for me mano kasi itong CDC yung volatile. So for me, I don't like this stock, no. Pwede tayo makakita ng iba dito, but for now I will wait what is the next action of price action of CDC. So next one is DLM, no. We will see the Del Monte Pacific. Yung Del Monte Pacific ay tumataas na ito nung nakaraan mga weeks. So actually nag-gap up nga siya dito, no? Gap down, no? Rather gap down. So for me, mahina pa yung ano ko dito sa, kasi dito baka mauntog lang siya diyan. and he will retrace back on this area. So I need him to go back to this area. Okay. So kung tumataas siya dito, this is the base area for DLLM. But for now, my bias, I will wait DLLM to go back on this area. So baka bumalik siya dito, no? And then we'll go down. So let us see another one. We have IRC. For IRC, this is company is Philippine and Pradeep Holdings. Maganda yung pinakita ng IRC ngayon, but nandito po siya sa EME 200. So tatlong araw na po siya na nandiyan, no? Okay, let us see what is the next price action of IRC. If we will going back here, and then you see a pattern, importante po yung pattern, no? To determine if the buyer is aggressive or not. So makikita natin yun based on the pattern. So in trading this stock, we need to see first the pattern if there is aggressiveness of the buyer. Hindi po pwede bili ng bili tayo, no? Kasi in the stock market, we need to buy it by low price and then sell it on the high price para po makakuha tayo ng profit. Okay? So if it is in the resistance area like this, this is prone to go to retracement. Otherwise, if he will go up here and then go down back to retest the support, the resistance which is become support. So yun lang po yung ano natin sa stock market. We need to see first the action, the price action, and then you can participate if it is in your bias. When we say that the buyer is aggressive, so you will look for an opportunity where to position. So hindi pwede yung umangat yung stock, bili ng bili tayo, no? So nasa taas na pala yun. So next one, so for IRC, let us wait if he will going retracement and show a good pattern. Okay, next one, we have MHC or Wellcon. This is the last one. But for the other stock, you will evaluate this based on our indicator that we are using. Now here, if I will plot the box for this is the purse, no? See, I will use this by reference the first down. Okay, if ever Wellcon will stay on this area, it is good. And this support, kung mag-stay yun si Wellcon dyan, it is good. Now alanganin pa ito, baka magre-retrace ulit dito sa may bottom line, another bottom line, this red line. My bias, if Wellcon will go on this area, this is good for Wellcon. If we see our indicator that we are using, the ADX positive and negative DMI is all below 25. So this is a non-trending stock. So that's all for today, and you just review all of this based on our indicator that you're using. Thank you very much, and God bless. Just comment below if you have comments. Thank you very much. Thank you.